Parental discretion is advised.
This show is brought to you by Slice on Broadway, supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza, sliceonbroadway.com. And listeners like you, support this show at patreon.com/wrestlingmayhemshow. Just wait, just wait. Hey guys, it's the Wrestling Mayhem Show, episode 513 Tuesdays. We've been doing this from Mayhem Studios here in Pittsburgh, PA, a mere few miles from the site of Hell in a Cell with Mick Foley and Undertaker all those years ago. But I'm Mike Sorgat, Sorgatron on the Twitter, and with me is the crew to end all crews. First of all, let's go north, way north, with Mad Mike's of Poughkeepsie, New York.
I don't know if I'm that far north.
So you're up there.
I see a lot of things further north than me.
You're close enough to have been future endeavored by the WWE. You're up there.
This is true.
That is true. Also with us, the man from the mainstream media, and also sharing his conversation with Baron Corbin today on KDKA's website, cbspittsburgh.com. Ooh. It is Matt Carlin's mainstream Matt on the Twitters.
That's right, Sorg. It is WrestleMania mode at KDKA. The real job is WrestleMania mode at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. I'm a content machine. I just output words at a ridiculous rate.
One of the few people I know right now
for the week.
Getting paid to do wrestling news for a real jobby job.
It's true. I got paid more or less interview the big guy, Baron Corbin.
Journalism and back.
What a jerk, might I add. What a big jerk.
And also with us. Oh, you heard that laugh. That's a little familiar to you guys. He hasn't been here for a while. He's been in his fortress of solitude, regenerating his tissues in wrestling fandom. He is Papa Lunchbox at DJ Lunchbox on the Twitter.
Hi, everybody. I regrew my beard. I literally don't remember how to do this.
Hi, Beard.
Like seconds before the show started, I was digging around in my computer because that's a great thing to do right before podcast is replace your hardware.
Welcome back. One of the forefathers of the Wrestling Mayhem Show back with us. And we're going to play a fun little game because you have not watched wrestling since you departed from us all those weeks ago.
That's correct. I have not watched a single moment of professional wrestling.
So we've had a little game here. If you guys stuck around to the end, Mayhem Mania, and we're going to find out if he knows if it's a Mayhem Mania match or a real WrestleMania match. But first, please go check out everything at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Subscribe to the show and all the other shows we have going on, like the Indie Mayhem, like Midweek War, like the Raw Wrap-Up. So much fun stuff going on, including columns by Matt Carlins as well. He's really breaking it down here, especially going into WrestleMania. And of course, March Mayhem, our bracket to find out what the greatest match of all time is. Go click the banner over there and participate in the poll and the brackets and help us with that as well. You can also drop us a line at 412-206-WMS0 or that email address. If you recall how to do this, Papa Lunchbox.
Good times.
A good times at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. You can also drop us a line on our Facebook, Wrestling Mayhem Show, on our Facebook group, as well as over on Twitter.com/MayhemShow. And we're on Instagram. We Instagram a little bit too, so hit us up on there too. No Snapchats. Should we Mayhem? No, we probably shouldn't Mayhem Snapchat.
Yes, we should Mayhem Snapchat.
Ladies. And also thanks to our Patreon supporters over at patreon.com/WrestlingMayhemShow. I hope this hasn't changed from last week because I can't get to the list real easily anymore because they changed things. But thank you to our friends, the Jennifer and Matthew Carlins Foundation for Podcast Betterment, Ed Burke, Mad Mike, Alex Cars, participating in our Patreon in the bank, the old school Patreoner, Antonio Garza of the WrestlingRevolution.com, as well as Bo Diggity! Woo! Woo! Ooh, who pays so I can say his name like that. You can too. You don't have to get the Patreon. You can just share the show, comment on the show, rate the show on iTunes, or share it with your friends, video and audio versions, wherever you're finding it on the internets, from the website. And just help the Mayhem Nation grow. There's a lot of people checking out our videos in recent weeks. Thank you so much to our new viewers. I hope you are enjoying it. And please give us feedback. Let us know what you think of the show, especially if you're new to it. And why are you listening? Where'd you come from? Or tell us your Mayhem origin story. We heard Lunchbox's Mayhem origin story on the Facebook in the video from our friends looking for group earlier in the year. We'd like to hear yours too. How did you discover us and why are you sticking around? Let us know. So let's get into the show. Matt Carlins, how are we going to proceed with this? Now, this is a grand, we're going to start with a game of sorts, which is something we don't typically do, but we kind of have to.
Well, and I'm really excited because once I learned of LB's complete ignorance to the world of professional wrestling, I knew we had to try and play this game. So LB knows how Mayhem Mania works, where we create all these matches for WrestleMania. So we've created some matches. So I'm going to play a game with LB. I've got like six matches here, and LB is going to have to guess if it's a match we created in Mayhem Mania or whether it's a match that actually exists in either WrestleMania or NXT TakeOver. So
I'm
LB,
so excited for this.
LB, are you ready to play? The game is, on your part, all you have to do is answer either WrestleMania, TakeOver, or Mayhem Mania. Here's your first match.
Okay, I'm on board. Let's do this.
Kalisto versus Ryback.
Versus Ryback? Superstars.
What?
I'm sorry. Don't check out the world.
No, that's not count.
That's okay. A funny answer, though.
All right, so Kalisto versus Ryback.
That's right.
Ugh, that's a
is this happening in Mayhem Mania, in WrestleMania, or TakeOver?
I'm going to say that's a Mayhem Mania match.
I'm sorry, you're incorrect. This is a WrestleMania match for the United States Championship.
Matt,
who has the United States Championship?
Kalisto.
What? Kalisto does. He's your United States Champion.
Matt, that was the best one to open up with. That was amazing.
I've deliberately looked for ones to mislead you, so don't be too embarrassed. Okay, are you ready for number two?
Yes, by all means.
Bayley versus Asuka.
Okay, so I'm thinking that they probably haven't been called up to the main roster yet. That sounds like a TakeOver match, so I'm going to go with TakeOver.
You are correct. That is a TakeOver match for the NXT Women's Championship. Good job.
All right. Does Bayley still have the Women's Championship?
She does indeed.
Excellent.
All
right.
Here we go.
All right. Are we keeping a record?
Oh, yeah. You are 1-2 so far.
1-2. All right.
Mad Mike will keep track. Okay. All right. Next match. Kevin Owens versus Sami Zayn versus Dolph Ziggler versus The Miz versus Stardust versus Sin Cara versus Zack Ryder. I knew this one was going to give Mike the giggles.
Is there a stipulation to this match?
This is a ladder match for the Intercontinental Championship.
Oh.
The sheer bewilderment on your face.
I want to know.
It makes my heart leap. Legitimately.
LB,
okay, so
which superstar is giving you pause right now?
Well, all of them, because they're all kind of on this same level, right? Mm-hmm. And if it was a WrestleMania match, if it was like Money in the Bank or whatever, or even for that, they would throw in somebody weird like Kane or some big man. Mm-hmm. I'm going to say that's a Mayhem Mania match.
I'm sorry, you are incorrect. That is happening at WrestleMania.
Yep. Now keep in mind. Now I have a question. If we had said Neville was also in that, would you have still thought Mayhem Mania?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, because Neville was supposed to be in it and he got injured.
Okay. Oh wait, can you give me the list of people in that match again?
Kevin Owens. Okay. Versus
he's the champion.
Sami Zayn. versus Dolph Ziggler versus The Miz versus Stardust versus Sin Cara versus Zack Ryder. But I have to say it out loud, it makes me laugh too.
All right.
All right, good job. All right, next match.
If you actually see how the Sin Cara, Zack Ryder, and Stardust of it came all about, it's actually pretty awesome. Because Kevin Owens basically dug his own grave.
LB, you know how everybody was getting hurt before you stopped watching wrestling?
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, that didn't end.
That didn't stop?
It didn't stop.
In fact, we just had a new injury this week.
Oh, who was this week?
Wait.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, hold on to it in case he was in a match that he was in.
Yeah, no. Don't. I will. Trust me. I would not spoil this game. This game is too much fun.
Yeah. No. Yeah. We've lost. What? Like we just mentioned, Neville was last week in Pittsburgh, or 2 weeks ago in Pittsburgh, and then the next week was Luke Harper, and then Miz faked an injury, and Bray might have been injured this entire time. So
he also may have been a ghost this whole time, like Bruce Willis.
Yes. Anyways,
I'm going to say like Katrina. All right. LB, you're 1-3. Don't worry. There's still time for you to rally and get back to a winning record. Okay, here we go. Next match. Okay. Shinsuke Nakamura versus AJ Styles.
Oh, that's got to be Mayhem Mania. That's pure wish fulfillment.
That is Mayhem Mania. Well done.
In fact, it was dubbed the jerk-off match.
I believe. Yeah, that sounds right.
I think it was originally.
Although, Shinsuke Nakamura is still a thing in WWE.
No,
it's a thing. It's a thing.
It's a thing. All right, here we go. LB?
Yes.
Next match. Austin Aries versus Baron Corbin.
That's a Mayhem Mania match.
You are incorrect. That match is happening at NXT TakeOver Dallas. The greatest man ever lived, is facing Baron Corbin at a TakeOver.
Oh, this is funny.
Since when is Austin Aries in NXT?
We need to make this a yearly tradition. LB, you need to take off 3 months from wrestling every year, then the go-home show to WrestleMania. We need to play this game every year.
If not him, we need to find somebody that can do this.
I kind of wish we could do this from past years.
It's like, this is better than I dreamed. Oh, this is so good.
This is amazing.
You're doing the people's work.
The great thing, sacrifice for our enjoyment. Especially the Austin Aries Corbin match sounds as fantastical on paper as matches we would make. Like, this is the point.
How long has Austin Aries been in NXT?
Like 2 weeks.
He's been on one show in person.
Yeah.
Well, good for him. All right.
Well, 2-5. You're a failure, but you know what? We're going to let you do one last match for you.
We could do this all show.
No.
These are
too obvious. Sorry. One more match for you.
Okay.
Blake and Murphy versus The Revival, formerly known as Dash and Dawson, versus American Alpha.
That's it.
Believe it or not. Are you familiar with the American Alpha?
Yeah, that is
Jason Jordan and Chad Gable. I'm not sure if they just gave themselves that name. I wasn't sure if you were.
Yeah, those are the guys on Jesus. Those are the guys on Vine that say Ready, Willing, and Gable all the time.
That's right. Yes.
Yep.
That's correct.
Yeah.
Also, Vine is still a thing. Breaking news.
Surprisingly, yes. I'm going to say that's TakeOver.
I'm sorry, you're incorrect. That is a Mayhem Mania match. Although, in fairness, there is a real match happening at TakeOver that is The Revival versus American Alpha.
So,
in fairness, but that was a bit of a...
All right.
But I got to tell you what. You're 2-6.
Okay.
I can't keep this going.
I got to say, I got to chalk this up as a win for you, as a win for us, as a win for... life, this planet. I mean, this is great.
A win for Mayhem Mania.
Yeah, definitely.
I have one last question.
Oh, yeah. I can give you more matches.
So WrestleMania, the main event. Okay, is the main event been set?
Yes.
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 Give me one participant of the main event.
Triple H.
Okay. I have no idea who he could be fighting. Is he wrestling John Cena?
No, he's injured.
Oh. No, John Cena's hurt. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Jesus Christ.
I mean, I just assume that's the reason that you quit wrestling was because Cena got hurt.
No. All right. Let me ask you a question.
All right.
Yeah.
Are you aware that Shane McMahon, Shane O'Mac, is back in the mix?
That I did hear about that. That was no news that I could not
avoid.
I could not avoid that. That did make its way to me, even in my exile.
Do you know that he's having a match at WrestleMania?
No. Last time I saw Shane McMahon, he was built. He was fat as me, and had long gray hair. And I think he was wearing sandals.
Oh wow!
Well, now he's fit. He is trim. He's been training. He wears a fresh pair of Nike Air Jordans out every single night on Raw.
Very nice.
And he is
flying off the top rope again.
He has a match at WrestleMania. Would you care to guess who he's fighting at WrestleMania? Shane O'Mac.
And please guess the stipulation as well.
No, that comes
later. No.
There's
I need you to guess the opponent. Okay.
I want both to be guessed at the same time.
Can we say pick one of the three stipulations?
Three?
That's a good point. There are many.
All right.
Opponent. Focus, LB.
Shane McMahon. And Triple H is in the main event, which means him and Stephanie are still around.
I like how we also have not answered who Triple H is fighting in the main event.
No, we just left him hanging there.
Is he fighting Shane?
No, I'm sorry.
No, that would be so good, though.
That would be great. Right.
That would be awesome.
Wait. I have a second guess. Is Shane wrestling against Vince, against his father, and winner gets control of the company or something?
No, but that is very close on one
you're
of the
stipulations. You're in the vein.
Is it for the stipulation on one of the men?
Is
the
it match. Stephanie?
Vince has assigned someone.
That would be great too.
Vince has assigned someone to wrestle in his stead.
Yeah, basically Vince set Shane up into the match. Fight this guy, pal. Yeah.
And it's for control of Monday Night Raw.
Yes.
Is it Seth Rollins? Is Seth Rollins back?
No.
No, Seth is
no, he's not back.
Oh, LB's looking such a bear at WrestleMania.
I don't know. I don't know who's left in the whole McMahon stable.
Who could they have picked that's not terribly
who,
in the stable?
Who would you like to see Shane McMahon fight at WrestleMania?
Joey Mercury.
Just quiet now.
I would like to see Shane. Seth Rollins. I think he'd be great against Seth Rollins.
That would be great.
Seth is still injured, unfortunately.
Let's hope that happens.
Oh God! What's his stupid name? Did they turn Roman Reigns heel? Was it him?
No.
Roman is fighting Triple H.
Oh, that's been going on forever. That was going on when I was watching before.
The chat room is saying we should give him the main stipulation.
No, absolutely not, because that gives it away.
I want one guess, and then I'll give you the stipulation.
The stipulation gives it away.
You want me to guess one more person?
I want you to guess one person who's actually a healthy, capable person who can actually wrestle the match. Stop naming injured people and making us depressed.
Everyone is injured!
Everyone can't be part of WrestleMania.
You said Bray might be injured, so it's not him.
It's not a bad idea either. Bray versus Shane. That's not.
Uh-huh. I would like that.
And it's handpicked by Vince. Yes.
Handpicked.
Oh, Big Show.
That is way worse than what we are actually getting.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, what's the stipulation?
Mike, tell him the stip.
Hell in a cell.
Just like Kane? That. No. Another very good guess.
Yes.
I don't know who is it.
I feel like we should give that clue. Here's another clue. The third stipulation, or it's Hell in a Cell. If Shane wins, he gets control of Monday Night Raw. If his opponent loses, he must never wrestle at WrestleMania ever again.
Is he wrestling The Undertaker?
Yes, he is! Aggregate age of competitors? 48!
This is so good.
What?
So are you coming over to watch it or not?
I love that.
Vince McMahon handpicked The Undertaker to wrestle Shane McMahon for control of Monday Night Raw.
That is a truth fact.
And The Undertaker was like, oh, fine.
Yeah, basically
I'm not doing anything.
Basically.
He basically said, I'm going to kill him, but remember, Vince, it's on you. I mean, I'm going to kill him, but it's on you, Vince. That's basically Undertaker himself.
So Vince was worried about him falling through, so he added the if you lose, you're done stipulation.
Yeah.
Huh.
So. Vince is trying to make sure he stays motivated. I want to do one more. I want to make you guess one more opponent, because this is way too much
I'm
fun.
I'm so excited by this.
I want you to guess Brock Lesnar's opponent at WrestleMania.
Ooh, yeah, this will be good.
Okay.
By the way, Bobby came
and
up
I
with
promise
the
torture will be over. And you
Bobby
can
came up for the title.
Want every dirt sheet you want, and just consume all wrestling news from here on out.
This is wrestling. Guess who?
It is.
This is amazing.
Guess who? Mania.
Okay, so fighting Brock Lesnar.
Yeah.
I'm trying to remember who all I've mentioned who you said is injured.
Would you like me to rattle off some more guys who are injured?
We can go through.
Cesaro
is injured. Uprox actually made a WrestleMania card full of injured people.
It's
actually a really great card. Like they.
That's how we should have done Mayhem Mania this year.
Only injured wrestlers?
Their main event is Cena versus Seth Rollins. You got Neville versus Tyson Kidd versus Hideo Itami.
Oh yeah, Tommy. Yeah, Tyson Kidd. Very good.
Dana Brooke versus Nikki Bella.
Nikki Bella's hurt. Yeah.
Nikki Bella versus Dana Brooke. Awesome match. I want to see it.
Daniel Bryan's hurt.
Daniel Bryan is retired. They made that as a distinction. They put Bray Wyatt versus Sting.
Yeah, Stinger.
Which is awesome.
Sting's hurt. Yeah.
I think they put Titus O'Neil versus Luke Harper.
That's pretty good. Like, the Titus O'Neil isn't hurt.
Yeah, but he's out.
Hey, guys. Anyone know where the key in the freezer is?
What the heck is that? Okay, I got that one.
But yeah, Brock Lesnar's opponent, Elder.
All right.
Brock Lesnar.
So, lots of people are injured, but it's Brock Lesnar and it's at WrestleMania, so it's got to be somebody big. It's not The Undertaker, and it's not John Cena. It's not Triple H.
Correct.
You said Sting.
All counts.
Sting is injured.
Sting is hurt, yeah.
Oh, my God. Brock Lesnar versus Sting. If Sting wasn't hurt now, he would be hurt after that.
Yeah, seriously.
If Sting were healthy, we'd be getting Sting versus Undertaker, and I'm very upset that it's not happening. But
next year, Matt. Next year.
Let's think those happy thoughts.
SummerSlam.
You said Roman Reigns is fighting Triple H, right?
Correct.
Yeah.
He's not doing like a gauntlet thing where he has to fight both of them and look real strong.
You know what? Just for the fun of it, I'm not giving that away.
I mean, this is Make Roman Look Strong Mania, so.
Who the hell is left?
Hmm.
You know.
Is it Kane?
No, it's not Kane. I love how your go-to is either Big Show or Kane.
Oh, yeah. They fit in anywhere.
I'm having flashbacks to Wrestling Game Show when whenever I got stumped, I would just guess Triple H. Yeah. Okay.
Is he fighting Vince McMahon?
No, but I'd love to see that. Oh, that'd be fucking dope.
Oh, wait, and
I did say Shinsuke Nakamura is a thing.
No leading the witness.
Kevin Owens is the Intercontinental Champion, and he's in the ladder match, right?
That's true, yeah.
And what's his name is the U.S. Champion, and he's fighting on Superstars.
Kalisto,
yes. All right. Is it somebody from Bray Wyatt's camp?
Nope.
No, but that's a very good guess. Strowman.
No?
No, it's not
Braun Strowman.
That's a very good guess.
That was a rumor for a while, and in fact, Brock did wrestle Luke Harper at Roadblock. If you're not familiar with Roadblock, Roadblock is another network-exclusive pay-per-view.
Roadblock was a card better than WrestleMania that they put between WrestleMania and the Royal Rumble.
Yeah, okay. It was a Saturday night show in Toronto, and I'll say this,
at Roadblock, Triple H fought Brock Lesnar's opponent.
That's a very good clue. That's right.
Thank you.
Triple H fought Brock Lesnar's WrestleMania opponent at Roadblock. We broke him. His brain wasn't programmed to accept an extra show between Fastlane and WrestleMania. There was Fastlane, and then there was Roadblock, and then there's WrestleMania.
Yes, because once you get on the Fastlane, then there is a Roadblock, because American infrastructure is not good, even though that pay-per-view is in Canada.
I can't think of who it could be. I can't think of any...
Well, let's
all the wrestlers that I'm trying to think of, we've already mentioned as injured.
The match is a street fight, if that helps.
A no holds barred street fight.
Yes.
Shawn Michaels?
Oh, wow. Oh, that would be amazing.
So good.
I don't know. I genuinely don't know.
This man was given gifts from Mick Foley and Terry Funk.
I don't think that's going to help him.
I know it won't, but I just wanted to state that.
Is it one of the Dudleys?
No.
One of the Dudleys?
Bully Ray versus Brock Lesnar is my fucking jam.
All of a sudden, we've got coming up with all these great matches.
All right, we got to give him really this.
Good. I love how LB is basically doing all of Mayhem Mania in
seriously.
We're not doing 8 weeks at next year. We're just going to do this in one night.
Papa Lunchbox, let's just say that you have named in a couple of times this person's other two partners.
And let's say someone not on the panel, but panel adjacent, is very excited about this match.
That's not going to help them.
It might.
Is it someone from the New Day?
Oh, we wish.
That would be so good.
Is it all of the New Day? Is it all three of the New Day?
No, that would be great.
I'll give you initials. I'll give you his initials. His initials are D.A.
Dean Ambrose?
That's correct. You did it.
That took way too long.
All right.
Fuck. Why is Brock Lesnar fighting Dean Ambrose at WrestleMania?
Actually, at Roadblock, Dean Ambrose cost Brock Lesnar the number one contender.
All right. So this was a fun way to kind of recap what WrestleMania is going to be.
I have one more. I have one more. Oh, I promise this will be the last one.
We promised him we were done torturing him.
No. All right, LB. Which of these matches is a real thing that is happening this weekend? Okay? Chris Jericho versus AJ Styles or Shinsuke Nakamura versus Finn Balor?
So are you counting?
I'm counting TakeOver too. The whole weekend.
TakeOver.
The whole WrestleMania weekend. Jericho Styles or Nakamura, Sami Zayn.
Okay. So I watched the Rumble, right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
So yeah. I know that AJ Styles is part of WWE.
Yes.
Right.
But there's no way that they kept him around for very long or even are going to put him in like a program on WrestleMania. So I'm going to say the other one. I'm going to say Nakamura. And,
nope.
Nakamura and Sami Zayn.
Yeah.
They are both happening.
What the hell?
Trick questions.
All right, all right.
I love it.
Okay, this is fun. This has been a great recap, but I want to can I just run down the rest of WrestleMania and TakeOver for LB,
because
I just want his reactions. I just want his reactions.
I just
want
to see his face if anything could beat his reaction.
I hope Sora just ladder match. Jokingly reads the rest of the Mayhem Mania card.
That'd be great. That would be great. No, I'll leave them to that.
And then it's going to be the Social Outcast versus
right.
Todd. Okay.
And then it's Biggie Langston versus Kofi Kingston versus Xavier Woods in a Smash Brothers three-way match on the Big Jerry Tron.
All right, so LB.
Did you say the Social Outcast?
Oh, no.
Oh, you don't even know who they are.
All right, right. That's another topic. Okay, LB.
Oh,
geez, LB.
I'm going to make the members of the Social Outcasts now.
Yes.
This game is so much fun. So, please, can we?
Yeah, maybe later. Maybe later. LB, this is okay, the rest of WrestleMania we have not discussed yet. So,
can I say one thing? Surely the leader of the Social Outcasts is Dean Ambrose.
No.
All right.
No.
Well, that's just a missed opportunity.
Okay.
Go ahead. Okay. Right. Give me the card.
So the card. This is the ones that we haven't talked about. Divas Championship. Charlotte, Becky Lynch, and Sasha Banks.
Okay.
Okay. All right.
All right. I got it. All right. That makes sense.
They're going to
Who do you think is the champion out of them?
Charlotte, surely.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
The Usos versus the Dudley Boys.
Ugh.
Tables match.
I'm still no. They haven't announced that as a tables match. I'm
oh, they
surprised.
Haven't.
No, I don't think they have.
I think they're saving that for Extreme Rules.
Of course, the third annual Andre the Giant Battle Royal. Which
okay. that's where Kane is, by the way.
Not much to say about that.
Oh, that's where Kane is. Oh, good.
I was worried he was injured. And no one was telling me.
No,
we would have told you. Kane would never do that to you.
Okay, and finally, I had to look this up because I can't remember all the names that are in this. But there is a Total Divas versus Bad and Blonde is the other team. As in Team Bad and the rest of Blondes.
You should have told them this one.
And this could have been a Mayhem Mania because it's ridiculous. The Total Divas.
This is worse than a Mayhem Mania.
This is the match Garza was trying to create for weeks.
So we have Brie, Paige, Natalya, Alyssa Fox, and Eva Marie versus, ready, Summer Rae, Naomi, Emma, Tamina, and Lana.
Is it just a match that so they can all get a WrestleMania payday before they're all fired?
Pretty much. And then on top of that, SportsCenter, the coach returned on Monday because SportsCenter is going to do live cut-ins to WrestleMania all day long.
I think you forgot to mention a match. You forgot to mention LB. We were going to have the New Day versus the League of Nations.
Okay. All right.
Come on, ask me.
Wait, you know who the League of Nations is?
Right? I actually do because.
Okay. I was gonna say.
I'm not pretty sure.
We can play Social Outcast or League of Nations.
I still follow Wade Barrett on Instagram.
Very good.
Damn it! I really wanted to play Social Outcast or League of Nations. That would have been a great game.
Wow.
And then again,
real quick, we talked about some of the NXT TakeOver. I'm trying to find a lineup for TakeOver, actually. But like we said, Sami Zayn and Nakamura is part of it.
Balor and Samoa Joe is the main event.
Balor and Samoa Joe.
Bayley and Asuka. You have Austin Aries and Baron Corbin. American Alpha versus Dash and Dawson, the Revival. And...
I believe the sixth match is Apollo Crews versus the Drifter. Yes.
Hey!
Anywhere on the planet. Yeah.
Shiloh! Fantastic. That's right.
Yeah.
Also,
I also follow him on Instagram and always like his stuff because
he's Shiloh. Oh, yeah. You're a friend of the show.
Actually, on NXT, just this past week, they had Shiloh versus Gargano.
Mm-hmm.
Battle of the Friends of the Shows.
Nice. Which apparently is what did we determine? That's a rematch from a Super Indie?
Super Indie 9.
Sounds right, yeah.
Yep.
I looked it up in my live tweet, Sorg.
Thank you.
That's awesome.
So now you've been caught up on the rest of wrestling. Wait, do you know...
Just real quick, can you give me the Mayhem Mania rundown?
Oh, jeez.
Mayhem Mania this year is...
Phil
Brooks is not in Mayhem Mania.
No. Are we you know what? Let's flip it. Let's go ahead and do your segment now, Matt, because I mean...
I will run down the super card right now. And Soren, why don't you call up the Facebook page, because we did have a vote to determine who is going to be.
Well, tell you what, before you do that, I want to give a shout out to our friend Slice on Broadway right here on the tracks in Beachview, helping us out, supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza, and now opening very soon at PNC Park with the Pittsburgh Pirates. But they've been supporting us for well over a year now, and with the podcast and feeding the guys the guests to come in, including we're going to have Shane in your face coming in later tonight for Indie Mayhem Show recording. And please look out for that and check them out. They're up here in Beachview. It's a little bit of a wreck because they're tearing up the tracks, but over in Kanagi, PA, on Main Street, and like I said, downtown, or actually on the north side, PNC Park, right there. If you go and check out a Pirates game, please swing by, say hi to Rico and the guys, sliceonbroadway.com, PGH_slice on the Twitter, or Slice on Broadway on the Facebook or the Instagrams. Let them know the Mayhem Show sent you. Matt, are you prepared?
Yes, I'm nearly ready to run down the supercard for Mayhem Mania, and then we will take a look at the results of the voting on the Wrestling Mayhem Show Facebook group.
Now, I have a question.
Reveal who will get the match on the pre-show.
LB, did you vote for the pre-show match of Mayhem Mania?
I didn't.
Okay, then we will cast your vote live on here. It could swing the tide.
Okay.
But not.
This is very dramatic. I probably won't. Okay, so here's the Mayhem Mania card, and then we'll do the pre-show match. The Mayhem Mania card is, first, Finn Balor versus Kevin Owens versus Sami Zayn. Next, Apollo Crews versus Brock Lesnar versus Bray Wyatt. Shinsuke Nakamura versus AJ Styles. You might have heard of that one. You also heard of this one. The Blake and Murphy versus The Revival versus American Alpha. Oh, this is an excellent match. This is the Anoa'i Family Expulsion match presented by Ancestry.com. The winner becomes the sole user of the Rock's cousin moniker. And if the Rock wins, the losers must leave the Anoa'i family. And this will be Jimmy Uso versus Roman Reigns versus The Rock versus Nia Jax versus Jey Uso.
That's my favorite. That's it.
That's a good one. I think we mentioned the Super Smash Brothers Melee match where they play video games instead of actually wrestle. Mm-hmm. Kofi Kingston versus Big E versus Xavier Woods. Bo Diggity had a lot to do with this one. This is the Family Double Dare Obstacle Course match. Winners getting 13-inch TV and a trip to space camp.
13-inch?
Seriously, Bo Diggity made that match. It immediately graduated.
Yeah, it was like the next person.
Immediately.
Mm-hmm. And it is the Social Outcasts versus Enzo Amore and Big Cass and Ty Dillinger and Kozlov. And I'm not telling you who the Social Outcasts are. It's too much fun.
We're still going to play that game. That's fun.
And finally, we have the Barbed Wire Hell in a Cell match presented by Lowe's. And it will be Dean Ambrose versus Drake Wirtz. You may know him as the referee from NXT, but they're all buddies from CCW, so trust me.
Great.
Ben made that one. She watches too much CCW, and she likes to watch the guys get beaten up. Sorgatron, we had a vote among 8 other matches to decide which one will make it to the Mayhem Mania pre-show. Do you have the results ready?
First of all, LB, do you want to make a vote on that?
I have the listings of matches.
Yes.
Okay, so LB, you need to cast a vote for whichever match you want to see. If you cast a vote, it could swing the entire tide of this.
Okay. And this is the one that will be on the pre-show.
Yes. That's right.
Okay. All right.
All right. First, we have Jack Swagger versus Tommaso Ciampa. Next, we have Eric Rowan and Braun Strowman versus Bobby Roode and Eric Young, who both left TNA.
Ugh.
Sasha Banks versus Becky Lynch. Alberto Del Rio versus Austin Aries in a Kennel from Hell match.
Oh, yeah.
Eva Marie versus Lana versus Blue Pants. Chris Jericho versus Dolph Ziggler. The Undertaker versus Baron Corbin. Or Paige versus Asuka versus Charlotte versus Bayley in a ladder match for the Divas Championship.
Wow. Well, shit, that Divas match sounds really good.
Yep.
Uh-huh. You know what? I'm going to have to go with Chris Jericho versus Dolph Ziggler.
Damn it!
I feel like they could really, really go to town.
Yep. I agree.
Damn it.
Good pick.
Yeah, I like
good
that.
Pick. Good pick, sir. Good pick.
All right.
John, who's our winner? Who's on the pre-show?
On the pre-show, it looks like it is Undertaker versus Baron Corbin.
Nice.
It was seconded.
it was one vote away from being a tie.
3 weeks from retirement.
And also, a second was Paige, Asuka, Charlotte, and Bayley in a ladder match for the Divas title. followed by Chris Jericho, Ziggler, and Eva Marie versus Lana versus Blue Pants. So, thank you everybody that voted on the Facebook and participating in your own little way in Mayhem Mania. Holy crap. It was pretty interesting. And also, Tragar chimed in a little bit over on his blog. As well on his version of Mayhem Mania, because he of course, you know, he had some thoughts and this was a thought experiment, and this is something, Matt, thank you for taming this beast for another year. That becomes Mayhem Mania. If you guys, we do usually put it on the end of the show because it becomes very unwieldy and we have a lot of people on the line. You know, and as you can hear, we had some really interesting matchups that sometimes some people, like I'll be here, can't really decipher from WrestleMania. So I think in the end, I think that makes the experiment a success.
Yeah, I think that's. I mean, all of those matches are entirely feasible.
So being somebody who is not stuck around, doesn't know all the storylines going into this, on paper, looking at these matches, did we book a better Mayhem Mania than WrestleMania?
Are you asking me?
Yes, I'm asking you.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I thought you were just speculating.
No, because you just literally heard the cards.
Sorry,
for everything
that was directed at you.
I'm going to say yes. I think yes. I mean, the main event is Triple H versus Roman Reigns. That's gross. That's gross. Come on.
Yeah.
You guys could do better than that.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I'd like to think that we did.
Even with the inclusion of Undertaker versus Baron Corbin.
It's just the pre-show. No
That's
one's gonna
the
get
pre-show.
Hurt.
It's all right. Now, I have a question. If the Undertaker's on the pre-show and he lost, would that credit towards his WrestleMania record?
Yeah, he's there. That's sure. Sure.
Okay.
Even if it was on the USA Network.
That's a good question. I was wondering the same thing when I was trying to decide if Wade Barrett having a match against The Miz before on the pre-show of WrestleMania 29 counted as a singles match at WrestleMania, or whether that's just – there's some, like, line of – delineation that just comes right down at 8 o'clock or 7 o'clock or whatever. It's just like, no, no, you wrestled in front of 90,000 people, but you were not at WrestleMania.
Exactly.
That shows up in the paychecks and the bonuses. They're like, no, you weren't at WrestleMania, but I was in the stadium. I was in front of like the 80,000 people. No, you're on the pre-show.
Nope. To be fair, I've been there for one of those pre-show matches. It ain't the full 80,000. It's 45, 50 tops.
Yeah,
there's about 20,000 just getting hot dogs at that point.
And souvenirs, because holy shit, the lines for souvenirs.
Ooh, yeah. I was happy. Mm-hmm. I got my collector cup, so I was good to go. So anyways, thank you so much. And LB, thank you for being a good sport on this.
my pleasure. It was a unique situation, and I'm happy that we got to take advantage of it.
So where are you? Are you returning to wrestling at this point? What is your status? Currently,
I am still officially on hiatus until the end of April.
Okay.
While I have moved house, I have not unpacked house. As you can see by the box. Shit.
Look at that decorative box behind you.
It looks like you haven't unpacked your cat yet, actually, as I'm looking behind you.
Oh, shit. I gotta let him out.
Are there holes in there? Watson! Meow twice if you're in distress!
But yeah, I'm officially on hiatus until the end of April. I'm going on, I'm taking a nice vacation in the middle of April. And then at the end, March 1st, I am returning in full force. Panel Riot will also return. I've been in contact with intern Stan, and he's raring to go. If all goes well, we'll have a new theme song and a new format, and that's going to be a lot of fun. And maybe... just maybe I'll pop in on the Mayhem Show every now and then.
Awesome.
I was going to ask if intern Stan was okay.
Oh, he's fine. He is as stoned as you've ever seen anybody. Because he doesn't have to work.
Oh, that's fair. That's fair.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. He hasn't found the new house yet, though, so that's a problem. He's just kind of wandering around the Target in Cranberry just...
I kind of want a podcast series of Stan looking for the new house.
It's very camera shy. Very camera shy.
Well, yeah, no, like a POV, so we don't see him.
It's all audio. It's just 20 minutes of silence.
In black and white.
Just shuffling around.
All right.
If Kevin Smith can make that work for like four movies.
Thank you, LB, for being back. I can't wait for you to get back in the swing of things here. With wrestling in the show and everything. And Panel Riot. I miss Panel Riot. I definitely miss Panel Riot.
Thank you very much. It will return.
And you can go back. You can go back and listen to all the past episodes over there at panelriot.com.
I can't wait to hear LB's take on Batman versus Superman.
Sorg, we can still curse on this show, right?
Yeah.
I thought you were going to ask LB if Batman versus Superman is Mayhem Mania or WrestleMania or... Takeover.
Fuck. Batman versus Superman.
Yay!
Did you watch
it? Zack Snyder specifically.
Did you watch it?
Yes.
I watched enough.
No, Jesus.
No. Did you walk out? Did you walk out of that movie?
It's for another episode.
That's for gold. That's for gold. Oh, that's for gold. But anyways, everybody.
I formally request to be on that episode.
All right. We're going to figure out what's going on with Matt's mic. We'll be right back. But check out indiewrestling.us. Matt's got a great Around the Indies column. You can check out things not WrestleMania, including I think we're going to be talking on Indie Mayhem Show later about what to watch in Dallas. That isn't WrestleMania this weekend if you're going down there. And also, side note, somebody give Eamon, the voice of Inspire Pro Wrestling, a place to crash for the weekend so he can go experience that as well. I'm sure he will
find out that his name is Eamon to please for a reason.
He will regale you with indie wrestling stories about Chris Hero and Johnny Mundo.
Please don't make Eamon sleep behind a bale of hay at Eddie Kane's
Go check out indiewrestling.us. You support the show there as well, including Indie Mayhem Show. We're going to actually probably go back to Will LB here, Papa Lunchbox, and talk about his Mayhem origin story from Looking for Group earlier this year at the 10-year anniversary party. And see what's also coming up, a great comedy show for a great cause at Dave & Buster's here in the Pittsburgh area. And we'll be right back with a big question.
As it's Matt Light, Pittsburgh Magazine's 2014 and 2015 winner, best comedian, and cancer survivor. Come check me out Friday, April 8th for a night of stories, laughter, barjitsu, beer pong, and prizes that will be sure to make this a night to remember. I'll be performing with some of the best comedians in the Steel City. Portions of the proceeds benefit the Testicular Cancer Awareness Foundation. Special thank you to our event partners, FN Vodka, Ultra Premium Vodka, Pittsburgh Improv, Pittsburgh's premier comedy club, Sorgatron Media, podcast, video production, and creative media, Pittsburgh Podcast Network, for Pittsburgh by Pittsburgh, River's Edge Radio Network, Pittsburgh's voice for local music, Comedians for Cancer, Friday, April 8th at Dave & Buster's in the Waterfront. The only place to eat, drink, play, watch sports, and laugh all under one roof. Get those tickets, folks. Go to barjitsu.com or showclicks.com and search Comedians for Cancer.
My origin story is Sorg and I used to get drunk at parties, and we would talk about wrestling, and then we decided to do it in a way that people could hear it. And we started with very few people, and now we have many, many people who hear it. And then we've been talking to each other about wrestling for 10 years, which is a long time to do anything. Anything. And those people are also part of the conversation. They also talk to us about professional wrestling every week. And sometimes they do it without us even there. They've taken the initiative to talk about professional wrestling without our involvement. It's pretty incredible.
We are back, Wrestling Mayhem Show. Please go check out that awesome, great cause, a comedy show happening there in Pittsburgh if you're in the area, or contribute to whatever cancer cause is in your area as well. Some good stuff. So let's get into the big question. So I was watching, if you guys didn't know, the Sting Into the Light documentary from the DVD that came out a few months ago is on WWE Network. I was watching it Saturday morning as I was putting together DVD orders for the Renegade Wrestling Alliance show that evening, and watching it as I was going. And they got to the point where it was about Hulk Hogan versus Sting, Starrcade 96, that year plus buildup that they did. And the change in character to be like the Crow and all of that. And I realized what, for me, that was a great time. That was, I lived through it. I experienced it. I was on the edge of my seat through much of that storyline until that match and scratching my head, which was reflected in the documentary. So the big question is, what is a time that you remember? So it might be partially a remember when as well. What is a time that you remember where the storyline, the buildup was long, short, whichever, but really kind of built you up and just felt so very flat, much like that instance there.
I think we may have all the same answer on this.
By the way, the Riz.
What instant were you mentioning there, Sorg? I'm sorry.
That was the Starrcade 96 against, for those who don't recall, Hulk Hogan versus Sting. Sting was in the rafters.
Wasn't it Starrcade 97?
Maybe. Was it 97? It might have been 97.
Because there was a certain special guest referee.
That's right. Oh, you're right. You're right. Bret Hart was the guest referee or enforcer and restarted the match. And this is after a year of Sting not wrestling. We didn't know what side he was on. And finally came out and this happened. You're right, because I think Starrcade 96 was Roddy Piper. So so there was that. And of course there was Hogan got a clean pin and Bret said, this isn't going to happen. And he restarted the match and really kind of screw job helped Sting win kind of, which was really, really awkward at the time. So what is something that's similar that you were really disappointed after all the amazing, amazing buildup? Mike apparently has an answer.
Sorg, it's one I was there live for.
Yeah, I think I know which one you're saying.
Uh-huh. Yeah, so you better come up with a different one.
Yeah.
That would be WrestleMania 20.
Yep.
The battle to end all battles, Goldberg versus Brock Lesnar. Ironically, also with a special referee.
Now, were you really into the build to that, though?
Yes.
Really?
Yes, because the build started at the Royal Rumble with Brock Lesnar being pissy and eliminating Goldberg, which I was excited about. And then it ended with Goldberg basically giving the WWE title to Eddie Guerrero, which is awesome. Mm-hmm. I'm like, okay, these guys both cost each other really big things, and they've never fought before. This is a one-time thing, and Austin is the referee. This can't possibly be bad.
And it's the subtext. It was one of the first subtexts of post WCW WWE war. It was
a big guy from WCW versus a big guy from WWE. They're going to brawl it out. It was supposed to be really damn good. And
I also want to say, this is the first time the internet ruins something.
Yeah, and it's also the first time. You can also say it's one of the first times that, like, this fan backlash thing that's become so.
Well, pervasive. I don't necessarily think
it's not
that
the fans' fault.
No, this one wasn't the fans' fault. This was the internet. But the match did not help.
No, the match was not good. But the fans, if they had been in a mood to play along, perhaps could have helped that match along a little bit.
Nope, not in the beginning. Matt, it was at least 6.5-7 minutes, maybe longer, probably longer, before they touched.
Giggity.
And you can do that if your guys like Ric Flair or Eddie Guerrero and you're playing up. They were just angrily staring because they both had better things to do after WrestleMania.
Yeah, like Brock was going to go on for his football career, which lasted half of a...
It lasted maybe one preseason game.
Yeah, and then he went off the UFC. And then Goldberg, I don't know, what did Goldberg do after that?
Goldberg was going to work with the Speed Channel or something.
Oh, yeah, that's right. And they knew, like Matt and Mike said, they knew beforehand, and the internet knew beforehand, and the internet always wins when it comes to things that that big. Mm-hmm. I'm holding Great Khali.
This was the first big match of the internet era.
Yes, and it failed.
Oh yeah,
I mean, it didn't fail on the point of them, the WWE actually listening to them, because at the end of the match, at the end of everything, Stone Cold stuns both of them and mm-hmm. walks out.
All right, pop quiz: who won that match?
Not the Goldberg. Fans.
I was there and I don't remember.
Goldberg.
Yes, I think you're right, but
I'm pretty sure it was his.
If you told me Lesnar won too, I would have believed that.
Nope. Well,
I think I won money on that one too.
So John Cena won that match.
Does anybody, yeah. Matt, do you have one that's not Brock Lesnar versus Goldberg?
Yes, I do. I've actually got a couple on my mind.
All right,
maybe Lesnar. I'll go with the one that I thought had the best build. WrestleMania 25, Triple H versus Randy Orton in the main event, and it was a nuclear, liquid, hot build with Randy Orton as just the absolute biggest douchebag you've ever seen in your life. He knocks Stephanie unconscious and kisses her while Triple H is handcuffed to the ring ropes. It's all timer. Let's see. Triple H invades Randy Orton's home, throws him through his front window. It was super nuclear hot. It felt super hot. And then Shawn Michaels versus The Undertaker happened. And you know what? The match itself was poorly... did not take advantage of the emotions leading into it. And also, it really needed to be like, they really needed to take the gloves off. And I know that, like, I'm pretty sure either Triple H or Randy Orton has actually said this on the record, that not only did they admit that basically they watched Shawn Michaels versus The Undertaker and were like, well, we're screwed, but also stated that they were hamstrung by the fact that they actually had to actually have this blood feud match under normal wrestling match rules. It needed to be like no holds barred or no DQ,
right,
or something.
And that
anyway,
was,
they couldn't really do everything they wanted to do.
That was,
Matt,
also a recounted.
The official rule was that if Triple H got disqualified, he would lose.
That's right. That's the title.
Yeah,
so weird.
Like, that was made an official rule in the match. So it wasn't even like you could have relaxed rules. Like,
the whole rule becomes, can he possibly compose himself, you know?
And
yeah,
within the first 5 minutes, both guys hit their finishers. Mm-hmm. Like, that was the first offensive move for both men. Orton hit an RKO and Triple H hit a pedigree.
Wow. Riz, do you have another one?
I do. It's kind of blurry since it was like a few years ago. But the clusterfuck that was the WrestleMania 9 main event. that's the toga party, right?
Yeah,
that's the toga party. Having Bret Hart and Yokozuna in a match for the World Heavyweight Championship, and then all of a sudden have Hulk Hogan win the match. I've watched that more times than I've watched anything else, like anything else in professional wrestling, and I'm still confused on how that match happened and how everything in that match like took place, how Hulk Hogan won by the first place.
Well, Yoko won first.
Yeah, Yoko won.
Yoko won first with Yoko salt in the eye of Brett.
But then Hulk Hogan came out.
Yes.
Like that part was just the fuck you, Brett, I'm doing this. Because I'm still confused talking about it. I mean, the build between Bret Hart and Yokozuna still waged on until WrestleMania 10.
Right.
A year later. And it was all because fucking Hulk Hogan. But it was one of those weird things that happened that I can't get out of my head. Like, I know he cheated WrestleMania. This is WrestleMania, brother. I'm going to slam you like I did Andre in front of 90 million people. But there wasn't really any – like, the build up to WrestleMania 9 was thwarted by Hulk Hogan beating him in – what was it? 16 seconds? Or I forget what random number he beat Yokozuna by, but it was a slam and a leg drop.
It wasn't even a slam.
No.
It wasn't even a slam. No.
Oh, it was a clothesline.
Fuji threw the salt in Yokozuna's eyes.
Oh, big boot, leg man. Drop.
Big boot, clothesline, leg drop.
But still, you can tell by my voice, I am confused already by talking about this. Just maybe that's why Bret Hart screwed over Hogan for staying. Who knows?
Actually, I think Brett has said in interviews that that was the reason he had resentment toward Hulk Hogan.
Good. Mm-hmm. Good. Mm-hmm. Good.
So Sorg. from well, I think mine was kind of the starter of this, but from the Facebook where I posed this question earlier in the week, actually, Cards was saying Rock versus Cena won. I don't see why Rocky needed to win that one other than Cena for the next one, which, yeah, basically, right?
Oh, hell no.
What?
No, Alex Cards. Absolutely not.
That's not what the...
No, what are they saying? What's he saying? Rock didn't have to win that match?
Rock had to win that match.
The Rock needed to win that match. For mental health, The Rock needed to win that match.
And that wasn't a great match. And that's not what you're talking about, though, Sorg.
Mm-hmm.
You're saying that the build-up didn't equal the match,
right?
Like, you didn't say the build-up. Yeah.
You know what? I'll say this. I heard that crowd after that match. The result was there. The end result was there.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Good match.
And it was
That's like saying Rock Hogan at 18 was a bad match.
It's right. Now,
of course,
said,
it was a bad match, but it worked. You know,
if he said Rock Cena 2,
that was no good.
Then I would have agreed with him.
Why are you mentioning matches I've been to live, Riz?
Because New York doesn't deserve nice things.
Hey, you know?
That's exactly shut up! What I'm saying
we got the last Shawn Michaels world title win. Damn it!
Wait, you were at the WrestleMania 9.
No.
Oh.
What?
No.
So is that
Roxana too?
Also from the Facebook, Gabriel Pierce out there in Portland says the whole year and a half build of Edge getting frustrated, winning Money in the Bank, winning the title, just to lose it 2 weeks later was deflating. Yeah, but still, the build up to the night, I think, was
that
tremendous.
The whole thing was the birth of the Mayhem Show, so it ultimately
succeeded. That is true. That is true. Like that was,
and it did, and Edge was so successful as the champion there, and he earned obviously many, many more titles.
Yeah, like if he swaggered after that, then yeah, that would be horrible.
Yes, and finally,
that is a verb now.
And finally, from Tragar, his prom night. So moving on, thank you. Let us know your answer to the big question on Twitter at Mayhem Show.
One hashtag. More Sorgy.
What?
Sorgy from the chat room. Heel Garza chimes in, Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal last year, all the build-up, Damian Mizdow turning on the Miz, and then the Big Show wins, F this company.
Yep.
That was,
yep.
That's I can't argue with that one.
Poor exactly. Damien's sad now.
Oh, we're all exactly. sad now.
Not even on the Social Outcast. He should be the fucking leader of the Social Outcasts.
He should be.
Maybe they'll unite during the Battle Royal this year.
So, anyways, from there, I guess we should touch base. We had a lot of fun, of course, with OB in the first half, and the matches in comparison to what we did at Mayhem Mania. But I just wanted kind of some closing thoughts through this, and we haven't really touched about the final few names in the Hall of Fame either. I of course Jacqueline's in there, Stan Hansen. Not to mention the Snoop Dogg. I'm down with the Snoop Dogg being a part of the Hall of Fame as well.
Sasha Banks better induct him.
Oh, that'd be so great. That would be amazing. First of all, any thoughts on Hall of Fame?
It's a weird class.
Not quite as excited, right?
It's a big class.
I'm excited for it.
Yeah.
Like, I'm excited for, like all the little names that are getting into it, because I've had, like, these are the guys, like, from the Attitude Era that I grew up with.
Right.
Like, The Godfather, mm-hmm. Jackie, I forget who else was in there from the Snoop Dogg.
Boss Man.
Everybody, like, that whole generation was 90-ish, some were in the 80s, but most were in the 90s, and I was there for all of that. I mean, Papa Shango was amazing when he first came up, mm-hmm. and now he's going in it as Godfather, but he's still going to be remembered as Papa Shango, the Good Father, the Godfather,
comma, and all the other Supreme Fighting.
Comma, yes, comma, chameleon. But just all these weird names that are being mushed in together, I love it. Go ahead.
It is an interesting class. Mix. And by the way, Legends, I just noticed right now on the website, apparently tonight, what site is that? Okay. On the website, they're saying tonight, Michael Hayes is actually going to be on WWE Network on the Legends show with JBL in that purple-ass suit. Look at that thing. And again,
it's red, Sorg.
I don't think
Can we
take
bets?
Is he going to do a live musical performance?
Take bets on what color his suit's going to be at the Hall of Fame?
Oh, it's going to be that. It's going to be that white suit with the red tie.
But I want to say he's going to dress up as a Slammy.
It's another one of those where, you know, like you raise, you're more Attitude Era, and even me being from the 80s, I'm WWE in the 80s. I barely know enough about the Fabulous Freebirds other than stories that Michael Hayes has told on Legends Roundtable on freaking WWE On Demand. I think this is going to be a good education on this kind of stuff between him, Stan Hansen, and there was somebody else in there that I was thinking about that might be in this. But I think they're very good at having that, you know, even Sting transcends how many generations. Mm-hmm. Maybe you know him from the late 80s, early 90s, or the NWO era, the anti, you know, Attitude Era in that same time frame. But I think it's a good spread of things. And not the holy crap, I never thought that guy would be in there, like Scott Hall, Jake Roberts, Kevin Nash, right?
Can we talk about the inductees?
The inductees? What's up with the inductees?
New Day's inducting the Freebirds.
That's confusing. Like, I saw that and my head exploded.
I heard that Michael Hayes has been kind of one of the big collaborators or supporters for the New Day backstage, and that might be part of the reason that they're inducting him, but it's kind of weird.
Yeah.
Like, especially when it was supposedly rumored that I believe Kevin Von Erich was supposed to induct them. Also, Slick is inducting Big Boss Man.
Which I think is the best news of the entire night. Is the best. Who is inducting Sting himself?
I would assume Ric Flair.
It's not going to be Vader, because Stan Hansen's getting inducted by Vader.
Okay, that's cool. That makes a lot of sense, actually.
And the Dudley Boys are inducting Jacqueline, which I don't know if that makes sense.
I think it does. I think it does.
I think it does.
Yeah.
I'm sure they put her through a table once or twice.
Yeah.
Yeah. But who would be good for Sting? Flair would be one. Any of the Four Horsemen.
Mm-hmm.
And after his induction, just beat him up for old times.
Yeah, I really think the Horsemen should beat him up after he gets inducted.
Just for old times.
Yeah. Just be like, Tully Blanchard, you're here? That's right, Sting.
Thank you guys
The only thing you need after that is for like to bring out like David Crockett and Tony Schiavone to start screaming about, oh my God, I don't believe what's happening.
Oh,
Arn Anderson just spine busters him as soon as he walks off the stage and then steals his ring.
Yeah. You just want
what if Ted Turner comes out for him.
Like you kind of want that. You like you want that slammy style thing where they're just walking the backstage and he just runs into all the people from his past. Like leading to the stage, right? Like that.
Yeah, everybody's gonna be there.
Yeah, but yeah, I guess so.
You got the Four Horsemen. You got Vader. You got Mick Foley.
Lex Luger probably won't be there.
Luger's probably not gonna be there. No,
that's sad. That's so sad. I mean, Luger is for some.
RoboCop's gonna be in the background for some reason.
Oh my god, RoboCop and Duck Sting. That would be the best.
Oh,
and they're probably saving it so they can induct RoboCop into the celebrity wing.
Yes!
And Sting back induct him.
You guys, I just realized this class has the Godfather and the Dogfather.
It's true.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Yeah. Wow. All right. From that, of course, TakeOver is going to kick things off. Like, well, like we mentioned, kind of a weird time, 10 o'clock p.m. on Friday. We're looking for a great, I think it's going to be a great TakeOver. And especially, I mean, this is the first time we get a TakeOver live leading into WrestleMania festivities. And even some of the talent has said, we want to steal the show from WrestleMania. And
That won't be difficult. They stole the show from SummerSlam.
They did. They absolutely did. But this is WrestleMania, Mike.
Yeah.
It's definitely a mania.
There's a lot of shows, Eamon, just on a broader scale. And I'm sure this will get talked about at length on this week's Indie Mayhem show. Like, the WrestleMania card is under assault like it's never been before. There are so many other great shows and matches happening around.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but this weekend you have those the indie shows that you guys are going to discuss in the Indie Mayhem show. You have TakeOver, and then I don't know. You guys probably don't follow this. The Walking Dead season finale is on.
How did I fucking know you were going to say that? How did
just to put it all in perspective.
I mean, they still have to fight for viewership because they can switch back and forth very quickly. So it's going to be one of those things where you have to keep your audience interested, even at WrestleMania, because there is something else out there for people to watch.
Also, we should probably mention WrestleMania is a 7-hour show this year.
7 hours.
Oh,
7 hours.
Wait, seven?
It's a 2-hour pre-show,
starting
a 4-hour event, and the 1-hour post-show.
And 24 hours at the Sports Center.
So I want you guys to all bring your sleeping bags. Those of you who are coming over.
You guys remember. Remember the WrestleMania all day. You remember the WrestleMania. You guys remember the WrestleMania all day long back in 2000, right?
Yes,
Sorg.
I got to tell you.
15 hours.
Then we have the
one hell of a WrestleMania party that year because it was this great. It was just like having the network. It was this passive thing that just got left on in the corner. So you'd be wandering around getting your drink, talking to your buddies, and you look over like, oh my God, they're playing clips from X-Pac versus Shane McMahon. Let's watch this for a second. You know?
Yep. Hey, you guys remember when WrestleMania was at 3 venues at once? That was crazy.
They should do that again. Just one thing about the TakeOver show. Riz, you were at the NXT live show in Pittsburgh earlier, and you saw Finn Balor versus Samoa Joe live, and I'm telling you, this is like the sleeper match of the weekend. This is the one that's like lurking. Those guys could go.
It could
like
go
all the way.
It can go either way for me because
nobody's talking about it.
But hear me out here. There were a lot of rest holds
like a lot of rest holds in that match. So I don't know if they're going to keep on doing that or if they're just going to do that for one thing or, but during the match that we saw, I think there was like a few just times where Samoa Joe just had to catch his breath. So I'm still excited for that match. I was still excited for the entire pay-per-view.
Well, and maybe he slowed it down because Finn was still kind of – I know Finn was banged up earlier this year. Maybe that was why.
Maybe.
At any rate, I think there's a very high ceiling for that thing.
We should make prediction for best match of the weekend, WWE-wise.
Ooh, what's going to be a show stealer?
Not winner's predictions, just best match of the weekend.
Mm-hmm.
On WWE?
Wow.
Yeah, like what match do we think – we will be talking about 12:01 Monday morning. Like it's we'll midnight.
All right, all right. Okay. I will say it. Shane Taker.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm with you. I think Shane Taker's the match we'll be talking about on Monday morning.
I mean, two 40-year-old guys fighting inside a cage.
You've got the son of the owner of the company versus the company's greatest attraction. The greatest attraction in the history of WrestleMania, like the longest tenured star in the company's history. If you don't think every bell and whistle is going to be unleashed on this match, Shane came off the top rope through the table on the go home. There is nothing your imagination can conjure that these people aren't going to think about doing it in this match.
Sets the bar high.
I'm going to surprise you.
I think I know where you're going with this one.
I think it's going to be the Nakamura Sami Zayn match.
Oh, well.
Mm-hmm.
I really think because WWE has like I was thinking of Divas Triple Threat. We've seen similar stuff. We've seen stuff like that in NXT. Bayley and Asuka, gonna be great. But the WWE audience has never seen anything like Shinsuke Nakamura. And I think that is going to be what people are talking about.
But here's my question with that. The ladder match next on Sunday. Mm-hmm. Does Sami Zayn hold off on things with Nakamura, or does he go full force?
No, he goes full force.
He goes full force
because it's probably his last NXT match.
That's also true.
Yeah, got to make that best of NXT Volume 2.
Mm-hmm. No, he's going to be on there.
Yeah,
anyway.
It's like Tyler Breeze versus
Jushin Thunder Liger.
Yeah, Liger. You get the big four.
I went there.
I am going with Divas title match.
Nice. I like it.
Those three girls have already.
I heard Divas and my mind immediately went to Eva Marie. Sort
of. Ooh, no.
I want to believe that is accurate. I just don't want to jinx it. But nothing would make me happier than to see them blow the roof off it.
We know what those girls have done in the past, and this is the time to show up. At least one of those girls has done a main event at least on NXT, and this is their chance to show, hey, we probably should be the main event here too. Those girls are going to pull out all the stops, and that they're working together. They're not being hampered by the old school girls anymore. Hey, they're retiring. And I want to see what happens when that steps up and what they can do on that platform. And I hope it's just the absolute killer match that proves women's wrestling, not Divas wrestling, is the thing to watch out for and the thing to look forward to at WrestleManias to come, not this 5-on-5 BS, every girl's in their match that isn't going to be honestly memorable or anything. They're just kind of there. Good for them for being at WrestleMania in front of 100,000 people, right? So that's where I'm at. I will go there. The Divas versus Bad and Blonde is the show spot equivalent to King Kong Bundy, Hillbilly Jim, and the Midgets at WrestleMania 3.
Wait, hold on, I'm not saying that people look at that match differently. I still love that match.
I know. Okay. Yeah, and somebody really loved the catfight girls, the Bud Light catfight girls from WrestleMania. No, nobody.
I recently rewatched WrestleMania 19,
and it was brief. And it got in and it got out and it was over.
Hulk Hogan.
Okay, so she couldn't speak English.
She could not say the name synonymous with professional wrestling and racism, Hulk Hogan.
Yes. He probably had a field day with that one, too.
Yeah.
The chat room, Bobby of J-Town. Also,
before we say what Bobby said in the chat, I really hope Sasha gets a WrestleMania entrance. Oof. I want her to come out on Escalade or in a carriage drawn by, like, black stallions. Like, I don't know. I want her to have a boss entrance. Because divas deserve that, damn it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. I love it. I you know, see them on that level. Jeez. One day, think about this, guys. One day, Finn Balor is going to get a WrestleMania entrance.
Yep.
Probably going to be against the Undertaker.
No. Well, he's basically, I think Finn Balor is going to replace Undertaker as that's the entrance to look for, right?
Yeah.
So.
Mm-hmm. Also replacing Rey Mysterio as the entrance to look
for. A little bit too. Yeah. Yeah. Guys. Oh, yeah. WrestleMania.
So from the chat room. I'm sorry, I already passed over one of Bobby's answers. I can't do it again. Bobby votes for Bayley versus Asuka, and you know what? Can't argue that.
Another good choice.
It's a great dynamic. It's going to be awesome.
It's a fantastic choice.
And by the way, stay tuned to the Midweek War this Thursday, where we will be predicting TakeOver Dallas.
Nice. Absolutely. Guys, it's been a lot of fun. Of course, we'll find out next week what we learned from WrestleMania weekend. But for now, what did you learn from the go-home week to WrestleMania or wrestling in general, if that's what gets you? And chat room, please answer as well.
I learned Brooklyn can suck it.
Whoa! What's your problem with Brooklyn?
Everything.
What'd they do?
The wave.
The wave? Can we talk about
the... You know what? Did you hear the origin of that, Riz? Kevin Owens said, if you like Michael Cole's commentary, do the wave.
And I heard how it stopped. I didn't hear the origin. I heard that that's how it stopped.
No, I know, but that's... I'm okay with that then.
I'm okay with that. Mm-hmm. I'm okay with that being how they stopped it. But them doing the wave, because they didn't like certain people in a match that weren't in that were in the ring that and their guys were standing on the outside of the ring, that's kind of childish, I think.
They got a Roman Reigns segment back to back with an Eva Marie segment.
Oh god,
yeah, that's true. That's true.
But I'll still no.
Also from the chat room from the last discussion, Garza saying New Day versus League of Nations will give us something to talk about. There's supposedly big plans for that. So Riz, what'd you learn?
I've heard about that too. I already said my thing.
So Mike, what'd you learn from wrestling this week?
I learned that Nike, if you need a new spokesman for your Jumpman sneakers, that is Shane McMahon.
There you go. He is definitely representing those well.
Only instead of like the Jordan classic, like split-legged dunk, it would just be Shane like flopping with an elbow just casually placed towards someone.
That could be the new swoosh. Matt Garland, what'd you learn from wrestling this week?
Oh, I learned a lot, Sorg. A lot of it having to do with that column that I wrote that we dropped yesterday about wrestlers having singles matches at WrestleMania. Did you know that Bart Gunn had a singles match at WrestleMania, but Billy Gunn never did?
Yeah, Bart Gunn had a match against Butterbean.
Yeah.
I know. And Billy Gunn never did.
Yep.
Nor did Road Dog.
I think the closest Billy Gunn...
More than both of them combined.
...is a triple threat match for the hardcore title.
Yeah, and didn't count. I mean, it's just... It's crazy. Jeff Hardy had one singles match at WrestleMania. One!
Wow. Great column over there.
Rob Van Dam. One time.
Column at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. First timers must seize the single spotlight at WrestleMania, and a lot of them getting that chance here. So there you go. Awesome. From the chat room, Bobby learned that even though Xfinity hasn't put up Aztec Warfare 2 yet, he did find a way to watch it, and it's slightly dark and fuzzy, but still awesome, although I thought Mentaza would have been bigger. But he looks like Slaughterhouse Bane, which is awesome.
Yes.
And Garza learned that El Jefe will not be denied.
All of those things are true. Yes.
Guys, Wrestling Mayhem Show, thank you so much. It's always a
blast
to be with you guys. Oh!
Yes, Sorg. Come on, Sorg. Everyone learned something here.
We all learned something.
What did Facebook learn? What did Facebook learn, Sorg? I'll go check.
What did MySpace learn, Sorg?
What did MySpace learn from the internet? Geez, what did I learn? We had a show this past weekend, and I learned they found somebody that looks like a wrestler at RWA. I don't mean that in a horrible way. No, there was this. What was his name? You ever like just you're at an indie show and you're like, oh shit, this guy's good out of nowhere. Like, that happened. Daniel Eats, I believe his name was. So look that up. Keep an eye out for him. I thought he looked really good at RWA. And looked like he belonged there. And I'm hoping they're going to do a lot more stuff with him. The crowd really reacted to him. Also, I learned I still absolutely love the RWA crowd. Between him, he really big with him, less so with the other guy. But there were giant "Let's go, new guy" chants. to the point where there was a talk segment, unfortunately, next with the promoter, and he reacted to it and says, "We're bringing him back. That's a great reaction. He is definitely coming back." That kind of thing, and I love seeing that kind of response. And again, that crowd is absolutely our buddy Stosh from Max Out came out for it this week, and he said he was really, really impressed with that crowd as well. Mother's got pal driven Riz. No. Do you even watch the product, sir?
No,
because you were scared away.
Yes,
there was some good, decent stuff on there. I definitely recommend it. That's available at RWA's March 2 Victory 2016. Over at indiewrestling.us. Also included Jason Gorey, friend of the show, against Sanjay Dutt and St. Shane Andrews in a tremendous three-way dance for the Cruiserweight title. Unfortunately, Amazing Red injured, broke his tibia and fibia.
Ooh.
Yeah. Ouch. Yeah. Hardcore. Mike, did you find anything over on the Facebook? Eads.
Sorg, Daniel Eads. I know we had tons of comments there earlier, but now there is just a giant picture of the Repo Man, so I assume he has repossessed our comments, because what's ours is his, and what's his is his too.
Huh. Also, hey, big props to friend of the show, Zach Gowan, who apparently has been booked on American Ninja Warrior.
Yes.
I can't wait
for
that.
So we found him then.
What? Oh, no.
We found him. Finally. I have been looking for him. I got a DVD called Finding Zach Gowan. Guess what? Still didn't find him. Now we know where he is. But still, check out that DVD.
There you go. Thank you, guys. WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Everybody check out what's going on over there. All the great shows and columns by Matt Carlins and Mayhem Manias and March Mayhem. We can find out, help us determine the best match ever over there. And drop us a line 412-206-WMS0 or the email address.
Good times
at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Subscribe on all the places. Join us live at WrestlingMayhemShow.com at 9 p.m. Eastern time. Heads up, we might be kicking that an hour early in coming weeks. We're still kind of figuring out the logistics of that. So we're going to well, the card subject to change. We'll just say that for podcast day on Tuesday nights. And from all that, check out patreon.com/WrestlingMayhemShow. Join us on the Wrestling Mayhem Show Facebook group. A lot of discussion happening there at Mayhem Show on Twitter. And, of course, our good friends Riz. Riz Plays Games on Twitter and on the YouTube.
Yes.
Doing stuff.
I'll probably be doing if I get the permission by someone, I will be doing some Mayhem Mania stuff.
Oh, yes, that's right. We got to do that. Awesome. Yes. Look forward to that. And, of course, that'll be shared on the Wrestling Mayhem Show channels as well. Matt Carlins, Mainstream Matt on the Twitter is, of course, great columns at Wrestling Mayhem Show and IndieWrestling.us.
Thanks, Sorg. More to come later this week.
Awesome.
Sorry. I was just working on something.
It's all right. It's all right. Also, look up his name over on CBSPittsburgh.com for some good wrestling-related stuff, too. And, of course, Mad Mike. Look for him on the Midweek War this week.
Yeah, I'm going to be doing the Midweek War. And tomorrow is going to be another long, vicious night of live tweeting. Because apparently my DVR has decided not to record Impact until later. So I don't know if I will be watching it tonight or tomorrow. We shall see.
And of course, shout outs to our friends in the chat room, Eamon, Bobby F, J-Town, Garza, and Wheels hanging out all night as well. We'll see you guys next time, Mayhem family. Mayhem out. This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com. Cool.